What's up, everyone? My name's Thomas, and today we're talking about why I left Adobe Premiere for DaVinci Resolve. So we need a little backstory. I've been editing within the Adobe suite for probably about 8 to 10 years now. And I started off in After Effects, went to Premiere. And over these years, I've had loads of unfortunate crashes that have cost me projects, lost me a ton of time, as well as daily crashes, errors, mix-ups, or even glitches. And back in college, I took a color grading course that really taught the basic ins and outs of DaVinci Resolve. And back then, it was really only for coloring. It wasn't an NLE. You would send an XML or an EDL over to Resolve and then send it back into Premiere or Avid or Final Cut, whatever you're editing in. And yeah, it was just strictly for color grading, and it was amazing at that. And a lot of people would use Resolve for coloring because Premiere wasn't known for having any good coloring tools. So during my editing career, I was really only editing GoPro footage and 8-bit Sony files. And even at that, Premiere was struggling with it. And those types of files require pretty minimal processing power. They're not heavy codecs, they're not heavy files, yet Premiere still crashed, it still messed up, and it still had a hard time playing back the footage. And I was editing all this stuff off of my 15-inch MacBook Pro, and I think it was a 2015 at the time, fully spec'd out, so these files should have been handling it pretty well. So let's fast forward a bit. I bought my Pocket 6K, and I was editing in Premiere at the time, and I noticed that Premiere had even more of a struggle trying to edit those 10-bit ProRes files, and it didn't handle BRAW very well either. The BRAW plugin was pretty much crap, and ultimately Premiere just struggled at playing back these higher quality files. And everyone knows you have to run the previews down to like a quarter or an eighth or even a 16th, depending on the resolution of your files. And I had to run proxies, which runs it through Media Encoder, which is another software that needs a pop-up that bogs down your computer. And really, even just the 4K or the 1080 files, they weren't really running very well inside of Premiere. So back then I was looking for just a new solution. So I gave Final Cut Pro a try. I downloaded it and the same day I just tossed it. Props to you, whoever can edit within Final Cut, but it wasn't for me. I really didn't like it. And I know people love it. It's optimized well and it runs fast, but it's not for me. So eventually I just ditched Final Cut and I wasn't really in the place to, you know, learn a whole new software just because work was so busy. So I just stuck with Premiere. So around the time that I was finishing up my work with Moment, I was editing all their lessons inside of Premiere and I eventually wanted to give Resolve a shot. And what's cool is that when you buy the Pocket 6K, you get Resolve for free inside the package. It's $300, you pay it once, you get free updates, but with the camera, you get Resolve for free, which was like, okay, because I'm getting it for free in this package, I'm just gonna jump in and give it a shot. And the value that Resolve brings is incredible. For $300, you get a great media organizational tab, you get the cut page, you get the edit page, insane coloring tools, you get audio editing, you get graphics, and you even get a great delivery page where you can choose any kind of codec, any settings to deliver your project. So for me, it was kind of a no-brainer to give it a shot. It wasn't like Final Cut, and it was more similar to the likes of Premiere. So right before COVID hit, back in February of 2020, I just decided to give Resolve a shot, and I fully jumped into it. So the transition period of switching over to Resolve was really quick. I immediately went to the keyboard shortcuts and remapped a few different things to what I was familiar with within Premiere, and that just made editing really quick and really seamless inside of a new software that is kind of reworked differently than Premiere. I immediately fell in love with Resolve. The way that the media tab organizes your files and you can import stuff in, it just works really well. The cut page is something I need to work on a little bit more. I don't really use that. The way that I pull selects and build out an edit doesn't really cater towards that workflow, which is fine. And the editing page is incredible. I love it. It works seamlessly, everything's efficient. You have everything you need within a reach, and you can toggle off buttons and windows to ultimately customize your workspace like in Premiere. And everything's kind of the same, so each project doesn't get messed up like what Premiere does with your workspaces. And that was a common thing with Premiere. My workspaces were constantly just getting shifted around. I'd try to drag something and a window would drag over, then I have to reset it. It was just kind of annoying and buggy, and Resolve, the interface is incredible. So back then I was primarily editing my Blackmagic footage, and BRAW runs like a dream inside of Resolve. It's optimized really well, and you get to have all the raw controls and even Gen 5 color. And DaVinci Resolve 17 allows you to have Gen 5 within that. I think they're updating it so you have Gen 5 naturally through the camera. But right now this is Gen 4 recording. And then when you switch over to Gen 5, it's a much flatter image. I think it looks a lot better on these cameras, but I still think C-Log 2 looks a lot better, and I'm trying to sell this guy. So some things that I love about Resolve. One, it's stable. It works really well, and it's only crashed like two or three times since really starting to fully edit on it. And those projects were the big field trips episodes, which have like 500 gigs of footage in it. And that wasn't really that big of a deal. It crashed once, you open it up, and you're already in your project. Running proxies are a breeze. You choose the file location, you choose the codec, you choose the quality, and you just select your files and then run your proxies. And it's all within of Resolve, so you don't need to go to a different software. And linking them and unlinking them, it just works really well. Like I said, I love the media page and just how it organizes things well. I know it's kind of weird because organization's kind of the same thing across, but the way that it works in the different windows, I just find myself being able to find files a lot quicker than I was able to in Premiere. I absolutely love the interface of Resolve and how your workspaces don't get all wonky and all kind of shifted around. I love that you can switch between a single viewer, a double viewer, and in the coloring page on a larger screen, you have all your scopes, histograms, all your tools, everything is at your fingertips. And you're able to select if you want to see your notes, if you want to see the effects, the timeline, the clips. Everything just works really well. And from start to finish, it's an incredible process. Coloring is one of my favorite things to do right now. And Resolve is notorious for coloring. And I really didn't like coloring inside of Premiere. Lumetri would always crash, especially when you add a LUT, like a Rec. 709 LUT. It would always crash and just bog down my computer. And it always just slowed down my workflow. And having incredible coloring tools inside of Resolve, it's so good. Because ultimately, your coloring and your balancing and all of that is gonna be like your final image. And ultimately, I want the best quality. And if I can have the best tools that let me just get the exposure right, balance out the colors, the white balance, and get a solid grade that looks really good, I'm gonna choose that. I really love how all the projects are in a local database. And I could switch through projects instantly. I can go from a Patreon video to a YouTube video really quick, and I just need all my files connected to my computer. And with Premiere, I'd have to go and find the file, open it up, make sure that's saved, go over to this one. And I didn't really like how you can open up two projects at once. It just got a little weird and confusing. But the way that Resolve handles your project files, it's really nice. And you can even export a project to dump it onto a drive if a client needs that, or if you want to back up each project in your archive drive. And I love how you can sync audio and create multicams pretty seamlessly. You do that within the cut page, and you could sync through timecode, waveform, I think start and stop. I don't really use those. I mostly just use audio and waveform, and it works really well. And the way that multicams run, it's pretty much flawless. When it comes to dislikes, there's really only one thing I can think of, and it's a known bug that should be getting fixed soon, and it's just anti-aliasing when you scale down footage or an image over a white background. Usually you'll get a line at the bottom or on the right side of it. It's like a 1 pixel width across the sides, but it's fine. I just crop down a little bit on all the sides. For some reason, it makes it work, but it's not the end of the world. But really, other than that, I can't think of anything that I dislike about Resolve. So I have to say that I'm impressed. Resolve has done a great job at giving you everything you need from start to finish and keeping you inside of the software, ultimately making your workflow a lot faster. I was quick in Premiere before, but I think I'm quicker in Resolve now, especially since it's so optimized well and everything is at my fingertips. And everything I need is just so simple. I don't need to dig into the software to find it. It just makes the process so much quicker. Resolve just feels much more refined than Premiere. And it's funny because it was just a coloring software before, but now it's a full-blown NLE with incredible coloring tools. And I can't really ask for much more than that. It works really well. It's $300 and you buy it once and there's no subscription, which that's one major downside of Premiere. It's $50 a month for like the full editing suite, or like 25 for Premiere. It just adds up too much for a buggy software that just crashes all the time and something you can't rely on. So should you switch to Resolve? I would say yes, or at least give it a try. Now you might be afraid of going to something unfamiliar or taking the time to learn a whole new software. I keep seeing memes and jokes of people that experience Premiere not being stable and crashing a bunch, but yet they're still staying inside of Premiere. I just don't really think that mindset works well. Like if something's not working well, find something new that makes your work quicker, easier, and more efficient so you can get more work done or rest more instead of spending time troubleshooting Premiere, why it keeps crashing, why you keep getting the beach ball of death. I was definitely in that spot before, especially with Final Cut Pro trying to switch over and kind of thinking about switching to Resolve. And I'm ultimately glad that I switched over. I don't miss Premiere once. I'm so glad I took like pretty much the week to figure out Resolve. But yeah, I urge you to make the jump and just get inside of Resolve. Pretty much just jump in and learn the software. It's super easy and it's well worth it, especially if you're inside of Premiere and want something familiar to that kind of workflow. Ultimately, it's an amazing piece of software that gives you incredible coloring tools, and I love coloring, and it's just a huge bonus to have a solid NLE that is built out and having great coloring tools. It's definitely my favorite part of that. So yeah, that's it. I've officially moved over to Resolve and I'm stoked. I'd love to hear what kind of software you're using, and if you're thinking about switching or if you're not, I'd love to know the reasons why. Leave a comment below, and if you have any questions about Resolve and that jump, send me a DM and we'll chat and I'll help you walk through that process. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Forgot to mention, I got a new light. I bought it off of Sam and I don't have the softbox yet, but I'm bouncing it in this corner right here. And I think it's looking pretty good. And I moved my desk over to this side. It was over here. So just trying to get everything dialed in and really just produce the highest quality stuff. So yeah, with all that being said, see you in the next one. Take it easy. Peace.